So I got back from Chef Schoen yesterday. That was my big tourist day out to the Blue City. I got lost in the Medina for an hour and a half when I got back, and it was pretty intense. So I'm going to tell you about that in a separate video. So today's my penultimate day in Fez. Maya has gone off to buy train tickets for Marrakesh, and we're leaving in 2 days' time. So today it's late afternoon. I'm just stepping out to go to a cafe, have something to eat and drink. I need to get some money. There is an ATM in the Medina, so I need to find that, take some cash out. But I'm just having a really chilled out, lazy day today, mostly air conditioned because it's 42 degrees out at the moment. Even though it's about 4 p.m, it's still really, really hot. So I'm just gonna head off and look for the ATM, find a cafe and sit down. And it's quite incredible because if you step into the sunshine here, it is unbelievably hot. But the moment that you come down the side streets that are very, very narrow and it's very, very shaded, it suddenly gets really cool. So you're sort of like going through the hot area and then you're going through the cold area.
A medina is the old walled city of a North African town, found in Morocco, Algeria, Libya and Tunisia. Fez Medina is considered the world's oldest and largest medina, founded by the Idrisid dynasty around 800 AD. Today it's a UNESCO World Heritage Centre. The medina is a tangled string ball of streets, all interlaced and woven together. It's estimated that there's around 9,000 in total. It's extremely easy to lose your way or think you know where you are when you don't. If you do get lost, try not to get stressed. You're never far from food and drink, and if you ask someone the way to Bab Boujlou, the Blue Gate, somebody will help you to find your way out. Just be prepared to walk fast to keep up, and tip them once you've been rescued. It's also a good idea to set yourself a budget of what you're going to spend in the Medina. People can be very persuasive when trying to sell you things, and you can easily spend more than you intended. Don't be afraid to say no or walk past without engaging. There's something beautiful to look at in every direction. Just before Eid. Every family is supposed to buy and sacrifice a sheep for this festival, a bit like Christians do with turkeys at Christmas. As a result, there were a lot of sheep on sale, being transported around the Medina on the back of bikes. Walking home, I randomly happened to bump into Maya and Taya. She took me off to see a couple of her favourite restaurants. The first is called Jardin de Bière, and it has the most beautiful garden imaginable. It's a total oasis in the sweltering heat of the Moroccan summer. I also managed to find my first piano in Morocco and had a little play. By this point, it was still about 42 degrees and the heat wasn't letting up. It was wonderful to walk through the garden and enjoy the pool. We found this cat who was also trying to cope with the heat. After that, we headed around the corner to the ruined garden, which I wanted to visit just because of the name. Fresh ice-cold lemonade, which was delightful. This is a common appetizer, You sprinkle spices on olive oil, in this case, a little bit of cumin and paprika. Then you mop it up with bread. Despite the heat, I was hungry and tucked into sizzling lamb with prunes and apricot. All throughout the Medina are little islands of shops, like the household goods market, the fish market, and the herb market. After eating, Maya took me to the henna quarter, where our friend Mohammed has a shop. The henna quarter is set around the Miristan Sidi Fledj, which was the site of the first hospital for psychiatric disorders. We sat outside under the tree, drinking traditional green tea with mint. The next day, we got breakfast at a local fruit seller's and picked up a bottle of this delightful nectar called Hawaii, a blend of orange, coconut and passion fruit. It doesn't sound like it would work, but it really does. It was sweltering again, so we took shelter from the heat back at the ruined garden with another lovely meal. Then took a look at some traditional architecture at Riad Idrisi.
It's my last night in the Fez Medina tonight. I am just getting ready to go up to our friend's house for a last night meal. We're meeting up just to, you know, say goodbye, have something to eat, have something to drink. And then I'm going to be coming back to do some packing. My time in Fez has been really interesting. I hope that I've given you a small flavour of what it's been like. I've only been here for 4 days, so it's not an exhaustive introduction. There are a lot of things that I want to talk about, especially travelling within the Medina as a solo female traveller. There's a few things, a few tips that I've picked up along the way, a few cautionary tales, even in the short amount of time I've been here, and just, you know, some other bits and pieces I'd like to share, but I didn't feel like I wanted to jump straight into that in this video. What I'm probably going to do is wait till I get home to Rwanda, and then I will do another video specifically. Oh, something just fell from the sky. Do a specific video about my thoughts about traveling in the Medina. Just because there's been a lot to take in over the past few days, it's been quite an intense experience, and I'd like a bit of time just to process those experiences and those thoughts before I kind of do a blah, 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 these are my thoughts on the Medina. So yeah, I'm really glad I came. I've had a wonderful time here. It's been particularly wonderful being here with Maya, my friend, because she has a house just around the corner, you know, and without her I don't think I would have had as nice a time as I have. I think I would have panicked more when I got lost. I think I would have got lost more. Although to be fair, in the 4 days I've been here, I have got lost a lot. Definite hazard in the Medina. But yeah, I just want a bit of time to think about it, to process it, and then to give what I think are probably the top tips here. So expect that video to come out, you know, probably in a few weeks' time. I'll let you know when it drops. So yeah. Tomorrow, we are travelling on a 7-hour train journey from Fez to Marrakesh. So Maya went and got the tickets today. So we're getting the train at 3 p.m. and then we're going to be arriving quite late at night. So I'm really excited to see another part of Morocco. I loved going to see Chef Chouan, and we're only going to be there for a couple of nights, and then we're heading on to Essaouira, which is down on the coast. So all of that to come. Oh, and I just need to add, because I always forget to say this, if you are enjoying these videos, please do give them a like. It really, really helps to spread the videos and for more people to see them. Drop a comment if there's something you're curious about or something that you'd like to tell me about, your own experiences. So yeah, just feel free to interact. Share the videos if you think that they're interesting. Yeah, I'm not going to do the hard sell here, but you know the drill.
That evening, we headed back to our friends Riyadh for a final meal before departing for Marrakesh. Our friend Michaela had just returned from the market with a surprise purchase.
We're about to do magic with the chicken.
No, well, a pasta.
Apparently it eats olive oil.
Yeah, pasta sopra del mio cucina.
And then it goes all shiny.
Sì.
Allora, I just first try and bottom.
Ah, that's a good idea.
And I think it's right. I think it's right. Let's see.
Right.
I tried.
Oh, I thought it would go dark.
Yeah, me too. But it's not.
It's not. No. Oh, it's bringing the colour out.
Yeah.
Oh, he was right.
It looks like
right.
It looks like leather, isn't it?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. I thought it would go all dark, and it hasn't. No. It looks good.
No. Looking quite good.
It was the right thing to do.
What's the chicken for?
Decoration.
I found this chicken so lovely and that I had to buy it.
We had pasta and salad with fruit for dessert and some yummy local sweets our friend Kenny had brought. It's sad to say goodbye to this place. It's such a tranquil haven amidst the madness of the Medina. Michaela is currently renting out rooms, so I've left a link below if you'd like to learn more. Meanwhile, it was time to head back to my own Airbnb to start packing. I'm ashamed to admit I'm a total mess pup. I like to spread out when I stay somewhere. Je ne regrette rien. I did enjoy staying here, but the bathroom is extremely compact. If you're on the larger side, you might struggle. Though they had a very ingenious way of storing spare toilet paper. Farewell, little house.